Hi friends, once we have completed speed time curve, there is one more topic that was left out, that is average speed and scheduled speed. So what are the difference between these two? Scheduled speed. So it's very easy. So average speed. So speed means it is distance by time. So average speed is the distance covered divided by time. Okay, you can call it as actual time. Okay, actual time, it is distance covered between two stations or two stops, or covered between the stops. Okay, and coming to second one, it is scheduled speed. Scheduled speed means I need to see the distance between the stops and I need to see the actual time of run, and here I need to add stopping time or stop time for actual time, then we can call this as scheduled speed. So this is the difference between average speed and the scheduled speed. So in average speed, stopping time is not considered, but in scheduled speed, stopping time is considered. Okay, now what are the factors affecting scheduled speed? Factors affecting scheduled speed. So once we know there is a difference between average speed and the scheduled speed, now let us discuss what are the factors affecting scheduled speed. So basically there are three factors. One is the value of alpha and beta is one factor, and maximum speed is another factor, that's Vm, and duration of stop is another factor. So duration of stop, so how much time we need to take for stoppage. So let's see, if for a distance, for a particular distance, for a given distance between the stops, if acceleration and retardation are more, the actual time of run should be less. For example, the distance is constant, it has been given, and if acceleration and retardation are more, then what happens? So actual time of run will be less. For example, if this is the speed time curve, yeah, this is acceleration and this is retardation, these are the times, so actual run is this much. So what happened, if acceleration and retardation are more, actual run of, if the suppose this is more and this is also more, so yeah, these two are more, what happened, the time, this time is reduced, and this time is called actual run time. So actual time of run is reduced, that means this part is reducing. As this part is reducing, scheduled speed is increasing. So that is the effect if you increase the alpha and beta. This is first case. For example, if alpha and beta are constant, what happened? If alpha and beta are constant and this maximum speed is increased, if alpha and beta are taken as constant, the maximum speed will be increased. Once maximum speed is increased, the time of run is obviously reduced. Once this is reduced, and this will be increased. Okay, so these are the effects of the acceleration and retardation on scheduled speed. Even though if you increase the acceleration and retardation, or if you make them fixed, then also scheduled speed will increase. Okay, that is the case. Now coming to average speed, if average speed is constant, if average speed is constant, duration of speed increased, so what happened to scheduled speed? That will be reduced. If average speed is constant, if average speed is constant, only duration of stop, that means stop time, is increased, so definitely scheduled speed is reduced. So that's what is mentioned. Okay, this is the regarding duration of stop. See, duration of stop, as duration of stop increases, schedule speed decreases as duration of stop is in denominator. Next, this is very important case. So station stoppage time has very much effect on schedule speed in case of urban and suburban stations, because in urban and suburban stations there are so many stops, so the stoppage time is very important. If you keep the stoppage time as less as possible, you will get very good schedule speed. So the stop time, station stops in case of urban and suburban services are kept very small to increase the schedule speed, otherwise it will be very less. Yes, if the distance between the stops is more, for example, if this is more, distance between the stops is more, so the stop time has a very less impact on schedule speed. But if the distance is very less, schedules, the stop time has much influence on the schedule speed. That means in mainline service, as we know, distance between the stops is more, so the impact on stop time is very less. Impact is very less. But in urban and suburban cases, the distance is very less, so the stop time has a greater impact on schedule speed. So if your stop time is more, schedule speed is less. So we need to maintain very less stop times in both urban and suburban services. So this is the explanation for average speed, schedule speed, and factors affecting schedule speed. Thank you very much.